Hello and welcome to a new KLANG tutorial. In our last video, we talked about KLANG controller for musicians. This week, it's all about the techs and integrators. We're going to cover remote management solutions, security features, and a couple of real-world examples on how to get the maximum flexibility out of controller while making it quick and easy to manage installation with many devices. To get started, let's take a look at how controller shows up in KLANG app. Here we can see all connected KLANG devices. In my case, that's one KLANG Vocal and two KLANG controllers. Let's make sure we're seeing the selected one by identifying the device. Yep, that's the one. We can assign a mix to the selected controller as well as a master EQ. In case you're using KLANG controller like a mini monitor console, where you are supporting the musicians in creating their initial mixes from the side of stage or front of house, you can enable the follow this app function. Together with the done to follow function, this allows us not only to operate any musician's mix, we can also listen in through the same headphone amp, ensuring quick and spot on changes. The routing screen allows us to choose which signal is sent out of KLANG controller via Dante, as well as the analog lineouts. Available pickup points are aux in only, true ambience only, the full mix pre-master level or post-master level, and finally the full mix including master level as well as master EQ. As we already know, we can use the controller's aux in to add a local source to a musician's mix. But we can also send this local aux back to our console via Dante, effectively saving two channels on our console stage box. Another application would be to allow the bassist to share their local aux in with the drummer via an analog cable between the two controllers. All we need to do to prepare this is to route the bassist's aux in to the XLR lineouts. An advanced example of the routing possibilities could be the following scenario. Let's say your band is rehearsing and the MD wants to show his studio arrangement to all the other musicians, who of course are wearing IEMs. Instead of pointing a vocal mic to their computer in order to make the musicians hear the track, we can apply a better and more effective way. The musician simply connects the laptop to their controller's aux in, and we make this available to all the other musicians. How do we do this? We simply route the aux in to Dante and then create a few controller return channels in our console. I'm using a DigiCo in this example, but the workflow applies to all professional consoles. These return channels are combined into a bus so we can switch between different musicians wanting to show something, which we then can make available as an input in our KLANG processor. And through that, to all the musicians. Another cool application of controller's routing capabilities would be an easy workflow to record all monitor mixes at once. This can be super handy for archiving, but also to help train new musicians. The first step to make this happen is to route all mixes pre-master to Dante. Then we use Dante Virtual Soundcard as well as Dante Controller to simply route all KLANG controllers to our computer. Select Dante Virtual Soundcard as your DAW's input device, create a stereo track for each controller, and start recording. From there, it just takes a minute to upload the recorded tracks to a cloud solution like Dropbox and make it available to tools like Planning Center. Quick tip, create a template in your DAW, as well as a preset in a Dante controller, so you can simply fire this up in a second whenever you need it. KLANG App's Info tab gives us the possibility to adjust advanced system settings. We can give the unit a name for easy identification, as well as set a fixed IP in case we need to. The IP setting can also be done directly on KLANG controller by pressing and holding the config button for a few seconds and entering the system settings menu, and then going to the IP configuration. The audio settings allow us to adjust the headphone gain to minus 12 dB, 0 dB, or plus 12 dB. This ensures that the musicians can always use the full range of volume control, no matter which kind of headphones they are using. We can also enable or disable an ambience mic boost in case the stage volume is relatively quiet or the musician is playing a quiet instrument. Dante Auto Routing will automatically repatch the Dante connection when we're switching to a different mix. So you don't even have to keep Dante controller open for this task. I'm just showing it here to illustrate the functionality. The auto unmute function is a very musician-friendly and intuitive way to unmute a channel by simply turning up the volume. You can enable or disable this functionality here in the system settings of KLANG app logged into KLANG controller. You can also enable or disable the relative group mixing. So you have the choice between KLANG style relative group mixing and classic DCA style group mixing. Okay, so now let's talk about a few features that will help with operational security, aka keeping musicians out of areas where they could break something. So we have the possibility to enable the group bank lock. If I do that, I can use my DCA groups, I can toggle between the two group banks, but all the other banks are disabled. So the musicians can only operate in level with the DCA groups. If that's not enough, we can disable the config menu access. And by doing that, disabling the access to the system settings. So no matter how long I'm pressing the config button, I'm not getting anywhere into the system settings. Also, we have the possibility to disable or enable separate DIM functions for the displays as well as for the buttons. This will greatly help out the lighting folks in case they need a blackout. The last section is reserved for support and service. We can factory reset our device. All we need to do is complete the serial number, which we find over here, and confirm that we really want to do that. We can also reset the error counters as well as enable verbose logging. This is a much deeper and more detailed form of logging, which also needs more memory on the device. So please only enable that if we ask you to do so. Finally, we can enable the temporary support access. This gives our support technicians the possibility to remotely log into your device through the internet and help you troubleshoot whatever might be worrying you. All you need to do for that is enter an ID and a password that you will receive from our technicians, and only then and with your consent, we are able to do that. Thank you very much for your attention. I hope this was interesting and enlightening for you. In case you should have any further questions, as always, please get in touch with us, write us your questions, and we'll be happy to follow up this video with a live Q&A session next week. Also, if there are any KLANG-related topics that you would like us to talk about in another video in more detail, let us know and we'll be happy to get in touch. Until then, stay safe, stay healthy, and see you all soon. Bye.